so I do not want to speak. Maybe I go to sleep and then maybe something comes out. Many people here who have met, have heard Dharma before, I think. So, well. So first, I think when anybody heard Dharma, or who heard Dharma, however, everyone wants to have success. Success, I'm not sure, for suffering or happiness. Some success, but I'm not sure. For suffering or happiness. But of course, everybody wants happiness. Even the person, I remembered something in London, who wanted to be eaten by somebody else. You know, who want his body to be eaten by somebody else. To be eaten by one human being, not a tiger, not Mickey Mouse, not beer. London, some years ago, one person wanted to be eaten by somebody. Want to be eaten by some other, he wants some people to eat, you know, somebody to eat his body. And he advertised, and somebody came. During his karma, somebody came to eat him. And slowly he ate. I don't know. But you see, yeah, but for him is that is happiness, you understand? Because about person who commits suicide, suicide, yes, but because there's some problem, what about relationship or some, it's too much, it become like mountains, become too much, so he has no space in the mind. So he thinks to commit suicide, so he thinks according to that mind, view of that mind, to commit suicide, then he thinks his suffering is gone, finished, things like that. But by doing that, begin the suffering, not finish the suffering, begin the suffering. Because we experience the result of the karma. So there's a continuation of mind. There's a continuation of mind, even though mind stop doesn't stop as a, wax finished, then the flame stops like that. Of course, the mind doesn't stop. Body and mind, two totally different things. Mind is there because which is a body, which is resistance. Resistance and form. But mind is formless. Mind is formless, colorless, shapeless, in which nature is clear, perceiving object. So, two totally different phenomena. So, anyway, so the view of that mind, even though we accept reincarnation, karma, but only a problem, your mind is not used in practicing. Even though intellectually you can explain, but when you get problem to yourself, your mind is not well trained normally in Dharma, thought transformation, Dharma. You know, the very special, transforming problem into happiness. You utilize the problem in the path to peerless happiness, total cessation, obscuration, completion of all the realizations. So peerless happiness, the full enlightenment, utilize. And doesn't know, and also not maybe intellectual, no, but not practiced, during the life. And suddenly you are left out. Your husband left you, or your wife left you, or something like that. So suddenly, then you see, the mind become the problem. You like balloon. You make bigger problem. You know, you labeled. If you didn't label problem, you have no problem. Because you label problem, so that you find problem in your life. If you didn't label your mind, you have no problem. So anyway, basic things, that. But, then you blow the, you become your, you made you as like balloon. So you made you labeled the problem, and then that situation you made the problem, you labeled the problem, and then you made a bigger like balloon. You blew the balloon. You know, you become so big, so you met the problem like mountains. Mountains that you can't move, you can't breathe. So that, and mind is not space. Even though you can, normally, intellectually, you can explain reincarnation, karma, you know, things like that. For you, by labeling problem, then appeared problem, then you believe. You have a huge problem, like you met your problem like mountains. Then you have no space. You have no space in the mind, and then the commit suicide. But so this really helps to not have suffering. Somehow very strange that mind normally intellectually explains reincarnation karma, but when you have only explained problem. Oh, because usually your mind have not practiced Dharma, not trained well in the LoJong, thought transformation. So then this is what happens. Then come to suicide using the solution. So finish your suffering, it's like that. But you don't think there's a reincarnation, there's a karma. that mind follows. If the physical, if body became disintegrated, what if the mind, continuation of mind, it didn't have beginning, continuation of mind had no beginning, and it had no end. So, even you may be explaining intellectually normally, but once the problem comes, you start problem. In the reality, you start problem. You have to experience all the karma, all the cause and effect, the dependent arising. Cause and effect you have to experience. So one doesn't forget that. So suffering, you know, the problem, you blew up the problem in being so big, so you don't have space to think logic. So not that. In Switzerland, we had one translator, he translated for my teacher, Geshe-Rakten Rinpoche, I forgot the name, very learned scholar, as well as a meditator, practitioner. They practice on the basis of sutra, then they practice tantra. So Mahayana tantra. So anyway, he translated. He was translated for those great teachers. But you know, one day his wife left him. So then he committed suicide in his house. He committed suicide. Oh, you see? So that's not only him. So anyway, what did I say? So you see, normally you need to practice. You need to train the mind well in the LoJong thought transformation, transforming the problems into happiness. Always keeping the mind in happiness. And here you see, you use the problem to experience, you experience the problem with bodhicitta. You experience the problem with the pressure toward enlightenment, bodhicitta, for sensing things. So, I say, you dedicate your happiness to the sentient beings, to numberless sentient beings, and you experience, when you have a problem, you experience the problems of all sentient beings. Like that, you take it on yourself, and destroy the ego, the self-cherishing thought, from where all the problem comes. Problem from beginning is birth, and now which bring the future, the problem. All the self-cherishing thought destroy. So you are one enemy. You are a real enemy, demon. The self-cherishing thought, dictatorship, or the self-cherishing thought, or selfish mind. Or they destroy that. So like that. So So you use your problem for enlarge, to achieve full enlargement. You use your problem with bodhicitta to achieve peerless happiness. Not just temporal happiness, to transform into that, not just that, to use the problem to achieve enlightenment, this total cessation of obscuration, completion of all the realizations. Use for that. You use your problem, so to cause happiness to numberless sentient beings. And to for them to be free from oceans or some kind of suffering, and bring them in full enlightenment. So use the problem, whatever you have, use for that, to help the sin, to free the numberless sentient beings from oceans or some kind of suffering, that ultimate happiness. Then the one that's peerless happiness, freedom from ocean, to achieve the cessation of obscuration, completion of the realization, so on to that. So ultimate peerless happiness to bring us into that, what do you use for that? So this is that's a fantastic, Dona Sangena or Jishalem, Chuganimo, Tongan Yamlinji, Changjo Sinji, Pepe Lanjuti, is the Bachu Kamba Chinjurus. What that's the way how to keep the mind always a state of happiness. So, in short, whatever appearance happens, bad or good in your life. With the practice of five powers, the essence of the whole Dharma, essence of the whole practice, whole Dharma. With the five power, practice of five power, and then the five power, the essence of that Dharma, then you develop the khasa, to bodhicitta. The conventional bodhicitta and the absolute bodhicitta. You transform your problem into you transform what is happiness, what is problem. You transform that into both, not only problem, even happiness. Your comfort you are experiencing. You utilize. You make it beneficial to numberless sentient beings. To be free from oceans or something, not on that. Oh, to bring to full enlightenment, or peerless happiness. So you realize even the happiness or the problem. So into the path of developing, into the path of developing the conversion of absolute bodhicitta. And then keeping the mind always happy. Keeping the mind always happy. In the West we have to know so urgent. So urgent how to keep the mind happy. Or how to keep the mind happy, or the most urgent. Most urgent. How to make the mind happy. you need to learn that. How to make the mind happy. How to keep the mind always happy, day and night. So whatever happens in the life, whatever appearance happens, bad or good, whatever appearance happens to you, So Kido Manda was happy. So they were there. So that's So I wanted again some moment. It's great. Externally looking very incredibly fortunate. He achieved mental coherence, mental coherence, tranquil abiding to mental coherence at Dalhousie. There's a group of monks, guided by to Jebe Rinpoche, one great High Lama from Devon Monastery. So after she finished studying, then became Larimba, like doctor, and then lived in the mountain, very high mountains, to mint it. So they lived in the mountains, and then his disciples came and meditated on the mountain, not so close, a little bit far. So he guided, and so in India, so he chose some monks and then guided in actualizing path to enlightenment. So there, my teacher, this Gen Chamong, achieved the which is nine levels, nine stages, and then Shine, the rapturous ecstasy of the body and mind, and they completed that. Perfect meditation. Only you can do perfect meditation after that. After you achieve calm abiding, not before that. So okay, he used to say, when I meet Dharamsava, when someone comes, he was like this, with the hands are like this. Until you achieve Shine, cannot do perfect meditation. You tell me like that, and that's very true, you tell me from his experience. Down below, he's on the Lama's elder tutor, he's on the Ling Rinpoche, past life. Down below, that there was a rock, big rock, and the earth, it dug, or I'm not sure, maybe Geshe Rabdin also, I heard, carried the tools and went down. Even Geshe Rabdin carried tools and dig. And so he lived there for 7 years. He actualized Shunyata, empty, Tongba Ni, emptiness only. There he realized, achieved that meditation. And the Geshe Rabdin Rinpoche used to tell, when I was receiving the Mahamudra teaching of first, first time receiving, Mahamudra teaching from Geshe Rabdin Rinpoche. So Geshe Rabdin Rinpoche used to tell me, if you have questions, you ask him, he has fresh experience. Above Dharamsala, there were many meditators on the mountain. So he was there for a long time, on the mountain, on the surface of the mountain, mountains. There many years he lived and actualized Bodhicitta. So he used to tell me that, he used to tell us, Lama, and myself, he has never been other people's house for himself. He has never been other people's house for 15 years just for himself. Never. Doesn't mean he hasn't been other people's house. He's not saying that. He has not been other people's house. He may sound like that, but for us it may sound like that, but it's not. He has been at house, but never for 15 years for himself, never been other people's house. Oh, yes, that's, so it means he has actualized bodhicitta 15 years ago. So that. Very fortunate. Externally. So it's my guru. So externally, in our common view like that. Then highest tantric realizations, not only completion states, not only generated states, but completion states, such as clear light, illusory body, Egypt, as six years Narva, like that, actualized. So then he used to tell me when we were receiving teaching from His Holiness in the private office, there was Jeffrey Hopkins and there were many of the lamas, not in the main temple, in the office. Coming back to Tishita, and he tell me his experiences, with great success in the actualizing part, even the highest tantric part. He used to go for his own teachings. One day thief came in the house. So what thief can find, nothing else. Only what he think available for him is the clock. That's the only thing. Only that was taken. That was the only thing for his mind. Well. So that was taken, stolen. So again, Chamondo was so happy because he got something which he liked. He got something which makes him most happy. So he was so happy. My claw was taken. He was so happy. Oh, like that. You see, like that. You see, happiness is up to your mind, not happiness, not outside. You understand? For some people, lost the call, we're so sad, we'll call the police and put in prison and, kill me right now, and, all that thing. Kill me right now. You understand? Terrible, most terrible. You see? So for some of the people. For that, like him, pure Dharma practitioners like him, makes him most happy. You understand? So the happiness is not outside, it's up to your mind. You understand? We should know that. When you have a problem, you must know happiness is up to your mind, not outside. Happiness is not on the clock, no? Happiness is not the clock. Your mind. It's up to your mind. So if they have the happiness in the clock, then there's no way to be happy. You know. So anyway, but that many examples. That's just one example. You know. So we shouldn't think happiness is outside. Happiness is up to your mind. Yeah, you have to. Your mind is the creator. Who is the creator? Your mind is the creator of everyday happiness and everyday problem. Your mind is the creator. You have to recognize that. Not the problem outside, or not happiness outside. So, example of that. Not only that. Those are common experience for ordinary people who don't practice, who don't know Dharma, or no Dharma intellectually but doesn't practice, or they become a big problem. But for the pure Dharma practitioners, practitioner bodhicitta, all of that, great happiness. Great happiness. That. And then one day he fell down, the aspects fell down. During the teaching, while we were teaching the private office, in the office from his own Dalai Lama, the women of the Dalai Lamas. So I think we were taking Hiruka, today, I didn't remember. So the Hiruka teaching, the title I didn't remember. So it was raining, so on the step, because it was in that aspect, fall down. So there was some blood coming out. So he saw this blood, he came up and his son asked to come to his son's blood. But later when we come back to Tishida, and Kishal told me, actually he experienced great bliss. He fell down, but what he experienced, not pain, great bliss. Oh, that shows the level of his mind. Do you understand? Level of his mind, realization, tantric realization, level of his mind shows, you understand? So, more we can understand happiness of the mind, especially when you have a high realization, all like that. So happiness, so basically what you have realization, not high tantra, but it's up to your mind. So that is for some people much pain, but again, some amount is great bliss. Certain that. So when he was going by car, taxi, he triggered this yellow rope. Yeah, this yellow rope was taken by thieves. And the taxi was lost, taken by thieves. So then we said, lost already, taken by thieves. You know, with the road. So TV thought to, I don't know what he thought. So took it. So he said, he offered him. So of course, I'm saying Latin thing. So anyway. Geshe Lama Gyoncho from Gapan Monastery, from our monastery. He was a meditator after he escaped from Tibet. He was near Tibet, very far in Nepal. Tourists were not allowed to go there. And, now they're allowed, but not before, for many years. So anyway, there was a Milarepa cave, most people would have read life story in the Milarepa cave. So it's the cave that Milarepa was offered woolen cloth, rolled woolen cloth by his sister. So, you know, some shovel or something to wrap, but naked. And so, so their sister came and sister offered a roll of woolen cloth rolled to wear. So Milarepa cut pieces and made pieces, put on his finger. Pieces and also down below pieces he made thumbs. So sister got very upset. So that cave. So there was the cave of that. There was several. There was another Milarepa cave that I didn't see, but that's close to Tibet. So above the Milarepa cave, this way, his sister offered a woolen cloth. So above that, there was a Geshe Lama Gondo's cave, where he never saw a person for 6 years, and he was in the cave. And we never heard, that story, only after going there. But we never heard, even though we lived together for many years, but he never mentioned that. And like that, in the, he was, when he arrived, when he was walking, going in the village, he was wearing the most ragged cloth, many patches, and the patches were torn. Even the village people, they never saw such a person in their life, and they threw dust. I think one family nearby the road threw dust under the bed, threw dust between the plank, so to dust and throw on the Geshe Lama Gondo while he was going on the road, because I never saw such a person like this. And then, there was a monk looking after Kapan Gomba prayer hall, puja hall. That monk taking care of the Gomba, the hall, he was some relative of that family who did that, threw dust on the, over the Geshe-la. So every time when you talk to that monk, he talks about that family who threw dust on Geshe-la. And so like that, anyway, so the people thought terrible. But he was great practitioner. His mind is in great peace, happiness. Even the outside looks like that. So anyway, So at Kapan, during the rainy season, so much rain. So the outside, old Gomba, outside the cement steps, you know, square, then there's a tara under the Bodhi tree, and so you see there. So summer rainy season time, so Geshe-la fell down, so heavily, jada, you know. Then his mind was so happy. His mind was so happy. He thought, but my life obstacle is rapping on him, he thought. Geshe-la thought, my life obstacle rapping on him. So the extreme layer. His mind is so heavily felt, but he felt great happiness. So great happiness at that. So you can see now here, you see, for some of the people, some other ordinary people will be so much pain and discomfort, and mind will be berserky. Mind will become berserky mind. But Krishna is so happy, unbelievably happy. So he thinks he received my life of straw on him. So he was happy. So again, please understand, happiness is up to the mind, not there, not outside. You understand? So anyway, what I want to say is so everyone success or happiness. So whatever the either the happiness is suffering nature or ultimate happiness, whatever. So like that. Now, other ones, believer and unbeliever. What one is a Buddhist or not? What the one is believer or non-believer? So even unbeliever must learn this if you want to have success. If you want to have success in your life. If you want to have happiness, you must learn this. So in the West, there's so many things discovering. Happened. So many things discovered. It happened in the past. From 1,000 years, 100 years, so many things discovered had happened. So many things realized, so many things discovered, found out, happened. So there's always things to learn. Even unbeliever, if you want to have happiness, success, must learn, must discover this. So the generally in life, to not have problem, to have happiness, to have only happiness, I'm talking on the basis of even a non-believer. So if you want happiness, you have to change your mind. You can't keep mind always. Negative mind, unhappy mind, unhealthy mind. The negative mind. Selfish mind. So, I tell this. Please listen. I tell this, you know, if you live life with a selfish mind, no thought of thinking of others' happiness, just even your family, even your wife, your husband, no concern of the happiness to your family, even your husband, even your wife, your children. So, you see, only think of your happiness, only concern your happiness. Don't care others. You see, even your family, even your husband, even your wife. Then because of that, somebody disturbs that, the mind, selfish mind. You see, what the selfish mind want, didn't allow. So you get angry. So you get angry to wife, you get angry to your husband, you get angry to your children. So, but then relationship doesn't last. I'm talking even unbeliever, you see, just you need to have a long-lasting relationship. So you will stay your life selfish. So you don't care others. So the anger rises, then the anger rises, what the jealous mind, all the garbage. You know, all that garbage in the garbage bag. Garbage the outside world. Garbage, not bag, audible. Huh?
Oh. Rubbish bin.
Rubbish bin. Rubbish bin, yeah. Rubbish bin. Worse than that. I mean, garbage bin. So. You know, I take there are text back out every day. The mind filled with the garbage, you know, delusion, anger, attachment, anger, you know, jealous mind and pride. What is there? There's so much more painful destroy the lives, but not by the garbage bin. The garbage bin, many people go in the garbage bin. In America, recent time, many people go in the garbage bin to get food. America, I think there were quite a number of groups going through the garbage bin and find food. And there are people who are living like this. So anyway, I just remember that group, there are many people living like this in America. So anyway, so then the relationship doesn't last, then you fight. If you are together, you fight. If you meet in the evening time, daytime you go to work, you fight. In the evening time is time to meet, so fight. quarrel. So you see, if I can live with her or with him, wow, no problem. You think, you never think problem. Oh, no problem, only bliss. only great bliss. Oh, you never think a problem. Oh, never think, only bliss. If I can stay with her or him, or only great excitement, you know. Unbelievable excitement. Never think of problem. One day goes, 2 days goes, 1 week goes, 2 weeks goes. Then you see more shortcomings of the shortcomings to the body and shortcomings to the mind. Shortcomings to the body, shortcomings of mind. Then you see person doing kaka and all that. Then you see, I'm telling you what I heard. Even physical together, but mentally far and far, 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 far. Then you see, you want to free away from that person anytime. Oh, the letter totally changes. As you stay longer, live together, then see the mistakes more. Then also more selfish. You find out more selfish. also mental mistakes of mind. If you can be, if that person lives from the house, or if you can be free from that person, it will be incredible bliss or incredible happiness and the life. then you meet somebody, but is finished. But then meet somebody else. Then you start again the same thing. Well, fantastic. It will be fantastic if I can stay with this person. Wow, no problem. Only bliss. totally different dream. Again, same thing happens. So, after you meet together, stay together, when that happens, again, do the same thing. So, anyway, what I'm saying, so even non believer need your meditation. Meditation. Normally, what's that? You need meditation to practice patience, to practice compassion, to practice patience and compassion. You need meditation, even non-believer, even who believe only one life, no reincarnation, no karma. Even that, you need to practice meditation. You need to practice meditation, patience, compassion. You need the relationship to last a long time. So even in the family, not in the world, even in the family, even with your parents, even with your children, even with your husband, even with your wife. So all of that. I need to practice, because I need to practice healthy mind, happy mind, healthy mind, happy mind. Dharma thought, Dharma, healthy mind, happy mind. Even the healthy mind, then the happy mind. What is Dharma? Then it's a happy mind, a real happy mind. Not attachment, excited, hallucinated happiness, not happiness. The inner happy mind. So that you need. So you see. So what I'm saying here, essence is that. So you see, you need to change your mind. Change from selfish mind, your dictatorship, the your mind, from there into good heart, the cherishing of concern others, the problems, the happiness, to eliminate, to concern others' problems, so pacify problem, obtain happiness. So that you need to change the mind, even you are a non-believer. So with good hearted mind, then you see you don't harm others. That is the way you do not receive harm from. You do not receive harm from others. Not giving harm others means you don't receive harm from others. It becomes cause of the result to not receive harm from others. Do you not receive harm from others who are numberless? So you are benefiting, you are helping others is the cause you to receive help from others who are numberless. You understand? That's you must learn tonight. You must learn tonight that. Sorry to say that, but that is so important. Even you are non-believer, so important. That is, we can see that. That is kind of a common proof. I mean, this is to understand that. You see, people have a good heart, everybody wants to help. Even the person has nothing, even the beggar, but a good heart, everybody wants to help. Everyone wants to pray for that person. Everyone wants to help. Like that. Person with bad heart, person is better, nobody wants to see. Nobody wants the person to come to their house. Person with better selfish mind, bad heart. When the person is coming this way, you go this way. You know? Person comes this way, you go this way. Yeah, you know, this normal thing, we know that. You see? always you see, everybody prays person with good heart. Even doesn't believe reincarnation karma. But you see? But with good heart. To add to the others who don't who help. So what the person is poor or rich, whatever, you see. So like that. always, wherever she goes, people praise to her or him, wherever he goes, like that. So what's that? So you know, that person with a good heart, wherever he conducts that, or wherever he is, she is, always there's inner happiness from good heart. The life's always happy. Wherever you are, whether you're homeless, whether you're living on, whether you're living on the, you know, house made of jewels, or you have no home, or how you are, good heart. There's always happiness. There's always happiness in the life. So even you say, His Holiness, you say, even you are living just grass house, hut, you know, the hut, like the, India or the, the countryside, live in a hut or the grass house, and no food, just drink water, but with a good heart, man's happy. That's inner happiness. You know, there's maybe not much outside. Live in a grass house, inner happiness. So that. Here my talk, what I mentioned today, the beginning, so even non-believers, you see, good heart, practice good heart. Like His Holiness often say, first think of others. Instead of you, first think of others, concern others. So that, you see, all of that, others first, not you first, others first, all that. So, So the khasa, for example, so you see, if you kill one, insect. With this self-cherishing thought, then become negative karma. So what happened, the result? So you will be killed general for 500 lifetimes. You will be killed, the other being that you killed. You see, the mind, there's always continuation of mind, taking different rebirth. So, because you are harmed to the being, so you will kill by that being. There's a continuation of life. The mind. So, you will kill generally. It depends how heavily you kill, but generally you will kill 500 lifetimes you were killed by the being. So when you practice a good heart, then you see the harming others naturally stop. It gets stopped. And only what you do is benefit others, give happiness to others. But at least you not harm with good heart. If you're good to build a good heart, this is what you do. So you see harm you receive past lifetimes being killed you, or they stopped by killing one insect. That result, you see what happens. Also, you don't experience. So incredible. So generating good heart, unbelievable. It's incredible. Best protection for your life. Your good heart is best protection for your life. You must know that. So even non-believer, that's what should do. To you want happiness, you don't want suffering. That's what you should do. That's what the all. Then you see the practice to others. Don't harm others, because they offer benefit, bring happiness to others. So as a result, then you see in the life, even this life, always others, they bring happiness to you. Always they benefit to you, as a result. It comes even you don't wish. Even you don't pray, even you don't wish, it happens. Because you create karma. You create the karma all the time. So it naturally happens. So that if you don't want to receive harm, if you don't want to receive problem, harm from others, then you see, after that is the first, from your side, first you change your mind from selfish attitude into good heart, caring others. Then you stop harm others. You need that first. You stop harm others. So others strive to harm too. So others do not harm too. They happen as a result. Even this life. So then you see, you benefit others. The result, then you receive benefit from others. So what His Holiness Dalai Lama often says, if you want to live selfish life, then you live the You live your life intelligent, selfish life. So this is what intelligent, selfish life wanted, or this thinking your happiness, to not suffer, to achieve your own happiness. Wanted is a method. The method is correct. So you don't harm others. You help others. Order from that, the result happens. Even though you don't wish, you don't have a particular expectation, it happens. Like that. But you see, if you are really practicing, that is what His Holiness says. To be, if you want to live life selfish life, then be intelligent selfish. That's like that. So that works. So, but of course, we really sincerely practice, that's not your aim. Your aim is happiness for others. Others do not suffer, others do happen. That's your aim. That's your wish, your aim. So that doesn't involve selfish mind. So that's good heart. Success is in your hand. Success of life for happiness is in your hand. It's up to your mind. It's in your hand. You see? Completely in your hand. So this way I'm talking. the liberation in your hand. There's a liberation in your hand. You understand? Even liberation from ocean samsara suffering is in your hand. It's in your hand. It's not hand of God, from only Buddha. It's in your hand. You understand? So then even enlightenment is in your hand. Not like that. So it's up to your mind. So they are saying, you see, Shinti Deva has mentioned, Karasurde, Dachin Jawa Machin, Zotang Yidu Mijure, Kwan Yan Dawa, Jidan Paro, Pasha, Jidan Jimiju. So, great Bodhisattva Shinti Deva mentioned that if one does not change oneself into others, you cannot be enlightened, cannot become Buddha, cannot be enlightened. Even while you are in samsara, there's no happiness. Even while you are in samsara, there's no happiness. Leave aside. The happiness of future lives, leave aside. The empower of Pasha, even though works with this life, even the happiness of this life won't be succeed. Oh, the person who has so much selfish mind, or so much problem, even to achieve the happiness, even to achieve small happiness, small pleasure of this life, so much problem they have to go through, they have to bear so much problem, difficulties, through that. So even to achieve the very short time pleasure of this life, even for that. So, since the time we always succeed. It is said by great Bodhisattva saint, great Bodhisattva Shanti Deva. What I want to say is one action benefiting others, one action, but two success. Your happiness, from there, so you see, by fulfilling others' wishes, first, if you want success yourself, first you help others' wishes to be succeed. First, you help others their wishes to be succeed, their wishes for happiness, succeed. Don't do that. Then that brings the result, your wish get fulfilled. Your wishes for happiness get fulfilled. You should keep that philosophy in your mind. That not just philosophy, that's realistic. That's the real seed. You plant the seed. If you plant seed, or the fruit grows. Fruit to the plant and bring it fruit. Same. If you don't plant, it doesn't. If you plant seed, then grows trees and fruit gives fruit. So the crops, you plant seed. So like that. It's like that. It's a real estate. Realistic. Like that. So your happiness, your success comes naturally. Your success of your happiness comes naturally. Comes naturally. By the way, the main work, maintain it, you bring success for others. So your success for your happiness comes naturally. So true success, your success, your happiness for others, benefit others. One action, true success. The other one, Other one is a selfish mind, even your happiness. And besides the happiness to others, there's no happiness to others. Even your happiness is difficult to achieve. You understand all that. So, even you are a non-believer, you know, must discover this, must learn this. So that this is how to make your life happy. This is how to make your life happy. So of course people who are practicing meditation, practicing Dharma, of course, much more, but that's much more, even non-believer must do this. Practice a good heart is the most important. If we want happiness, general suffering, that must do that. That's my beginning message. How much time? Some question? No question? I continue.
On the topic of happiness, what can you suggest we can do for the people of Nepal at the moment? What can you suggest we do on the topic of happiness? What should we do for Nepalese people at the moment suffering from the earthquake?
Only Nepalese? it's very long earthquake. I think how many weeks? 4 weeks. 4 weeks, 3 weeks.
Question.
4 weeks. It's very long. Very long. Sometimes a little bit big one. Never happened. The very first one is a very big one. Then there was another big one, I think after one or two days. I was outside. The first time I was inside my room, the bigger room, where they turned one tower, big size, and many statues. So all the flowers on the table fell down. Then someone came, and he hold the table. Very serious. Very serious. I think my mind was a little bit stubborn. I know the discomfort, but fear from down deep wasn't there. So my mind was spoiled and the stubborn, you know, like a stubborn person. Then secondly, the water, minimum the water bowls, all fell down, the full of water. The water didn't get clean, so what happened was that wood come up. The wood, water was there for, I think, maybe 1 or 2 hours. Anyway, so second house, we were that, we were reciting some prayer or something, and the trees went, trees become like drunk, you know, trees on the hill, like that. And then, yeah, then many small earthquakes, many small, then sometimes we will be on that. That's very unusual. Happening the small ones. Nepal. It's quite unusual. I think many old, probably 1,000 years ago, carved and ancient. You know, temple or something, I don't know, Buddhist or Hindu, many old, probably many hundred years ago, many carved, all ruined, many ruined. Some of course, every stables, many ruined, so like that. So we us nuns, we have a nunnery at more than 300 nuns. The very good study, excellent study, they do a debate, the philosophy, Buddhist, learning Buddhist philosophy, excellent study, known. So I asked them, please read Danger. Danger is more than 300 volumes. So read to stop the, even big earthquakes to become smaller. So they should have finished. Gilubha, the Gilubha organization in the Nepal, who does the, you know, looking after, study the monasteries and the philosophy, and they kind of looking after that. So I told individually it didn't come out, monastery to puja, but the gallery of puja, they told to Juma. So I asked them to do. So beginning they don't answer, because some even monasteries get ruined or something. So then later on they are able to gather the guru monk and to do puja. So that they did. So we try to what we can. And, I told to read the Bodhisattva Siddhikava book, one volume to read that. That is very much connected. So I help very much for earthquakes or any. To read that and the Golden Light Sutra also. So that, then, of course, even your. Recite Omani Bhimu Hung or any other invitation you do, the Guru Shatyamani Buddha or Jinri Tara, and then you pray, you dedicate the merits, you pray to stop the earthquake in Nepal, so they can help. So can help you dedicate the merits and to stop. Can help. Depending level of your mind, great help, middle help, small help, whatever. So that's it. Okay. Yeah, that's and then that and also maybe I don't know whether you know. So like atman and the precepts. This one day precept, taking atman and precepts. and then you dedicate for Nepal, to serve them, for you to have peace, to become, you know, to develop the peace. So, I mean, as well as the world, there's the world. So much suffering, so many people dying every day. So the army, in the American armies, after they survived after Iraq and those countries, the armies even survived, they come back. Every day, 20 army, they suicide. Every day. One American army came to Lao. Because you see, after this, what they saw in their life, unbelievable, this bomb and all this, something happened, killing someone. So what happened was, even they survived, but I think the question, their life, they don't know Dharma, they haven't met Dharma, they don't know Dharma. So they have no answer, what is the meaning of life? What is the purpose of life? There's no understanding. So then you see, they have no answer to that. So what happens is that then they think life is the meaning. So you see, the mind become, they saw so much in their life. People killing, some unbelievable destruction. So then they come back. So the mind really. So they go in suicidal thought. Every day 20 they suicide. 20 armies every day, he told me. He was quite high technology. I mean, spying, I'm not sure, involved with the, the machines and very high technology. He was, he's a guy, don't do so much. Didn't say much. So I called him in the cave. He came to near Mount Everest, Lao. So I called in the cave and had a little talk and gave him practice to purify negative karma. And meditation on Lamrim, steps apart to enlightenment, meditation on that. So he's a good practice for many years he has a good practice for, not 10 years, 15 years, and he got enough. So enough to do in life, you know, things to do. So I think made him very happy. So they got the meaning of life, and so he told me that's what. So that's why American government use mindfulness meditation for the army. I asked him how he met with Dharma, before coming to Nepal, all that, how he met with Dharma. It was American government used mindfulness meditation. There, both the armies, you see, now the mental problem. So they use mindfulness meditation there. Oh, so he got interested from that. Then I think he got, he maybe checked the internet and he found Nepal or that. So he came to Nepal, Kapan, then he went to root. He walked there, served the root, and then I came to Lato when I was there. Yeah, and then he came back to a root to serve. So anyway, So, is it a mental problem? So the government used mindfulness meditation in the armies. So to calm down the mind. No? So that. So reading, reading those Dharma books and texts, and then dedicating your merits, praying. And also, if you can, then Atmana precepts, one day precepts, Atmana precepts. Only white food, no onion, garlic, meat, no. So that dedicate your take precepts for the world peace and Nepal, to happen earthquakes, all that. And then you dedicate the merits for that, for all six realms, sentient beings, to achieve enlightenment as quick as possible. And then this world, peace, all the wars, all the problems, and Nepal earthquakes, that should not happen. So, okay? Okay?
Thank you.
Yeah. Anything?
Question.
Yeah.
We know how to prevent very strong negative emotions like anger. How to prevent manifestation of very strong negative emotions. But when they already appeared, when we already became very stupid, and when captain of our minds is anger. What do we do at those moments when the captain of your mind is anger or something worse? Because you have no power, no mental ability to deal with that. You're a demon at this moment.
I think in the Shanti Deva Manjuntra in the Buddha chapter, you can visualize yourself as rocky mountain. You visualize a tree or rock, something. You would think you are rocky mountain. So then maybe the anger goes. Then the anger slowly goes away if you visualize your rocky mountain. The other thing is, you put this, what you ride on waves, what is it called?
Seven
boats. Yeah, then suddenly, the seven boat, you put a car and drive to the beach and set boat on the waves. That time, I'm just giving you information. Suddenly, you see, the big anger rises because main thing, because believing there's a real I. Because believing there's an I inside. And that's I inside, something real I. So now the real I, if you look from tip of the hairs, brain, heart, and this beating heart, and all the different things inside. And then go down to the feet, Can't find. We pay a lot of money and you ask, operate, cannot find the doctors cannot find the psychologist, the scientists could not find the real idea. They will believe 100%, you know, from this morning, not only from birth, from beginningless birth. You know, it's there. It's there, not in the belly, not in the leg, not in the toes, not in the fingers, not in the fingers. With that stroke, my finger became like that. So, nowhere, you see. From beginningless birth, we appear to our hallucinant mind, and we entrust in that 100%. Entrust in that 100%. So you see, if we have influence, if we have power, influence, you would kill anyone you don't like. You would kill. Like it happened time to time in the world, killed many millions of people by one person who has power. So whom he doesn't like, was killed, or to burn the children in the fire and all that. I mean, it had happened million time to time in the world, one person. So because you don't like those people, or those people are. People you want only blue eyes and blonde hairs and something like that. So if you have power, influence you to that, kill many, many people in the world. Oh, you see, to achieve happiness for this eye, this real eye. You see, and if somebody blamed you, you put that person in the court and the prison. Somebody blamed you or said something bad, something evil you didn't do, and then you bring that person into prison. Or however, spend lots of money, spend so much money. So even you don't have enough for your living, but spend so much money, put the person in prison or whatever, person killing or whatever. So much killing, taking a life, whatever. So many harms you give to other sentient beings. To get happiness, to get power for this eye, to get happiness for this eye. So this, what do you do in the whole life? But this real eye is not there. That's the real eye. You look, if you check, where is it? Can't find. You can't find. Not only you can't find it here. You can't find it in your room, you can't find it in New Zealand, you can't find it in this world, the real I. Yes, there's I, what is that? There's I existing, yes, that is what's media labeled by the mind. Oh, that exists, but the real I, opposite that, existing from its own side. Or that, we entrust in that, 100%, no doubt, do everything for that. So, killing, stealing, to other people, suffering, to insects, animals, killed animals, others, for that. To get power, to get happiness for this eye. Wow, wow, wow. so much harm. You see, but if you look, where is it? Cannot find. No, cannot find. Because the body is so like this. Form is not I. Form as a feeling is not I. Cognition is not I. And the compounding aggregates is not I. It's mental factor. There are 49 mental factors. 51 mental factors and 6 principal conscience. 51 mental factors, and then from there, you see, the feeling is not I, cognition is not I, compound aggregates, 49 mental factors, not I, and consciousness is not the real I. So, in all together, 5 is not the real I. So the real I doesn't exist, cannot be found if you look for from the hair down to the toes. Cannot find. Nowhere it exists. Not now here. Not here. Not in the room. Not in Israel. Not in the world. nowhere it exists. But you see, what exists is. Please listen here. So, what exists in the main name? You see, depending on the aggregates, mind would focus on the aggregates. Then that mind merely labels made up I, or that exists. That exists. But now the question is, please listen. Now the next question is, where is that? That exists, yes. But where is that? Oh, that's the next question. So please meditate on that. So that's very good subject. That's very good subject to meditate. Where is that I? Where is the mirror? The I exists. Meaning? Yes, that's the I which exists, which achieve enlightenment, which experience samsara nirvana, which achieve enlightenment, which experience happiness, suffering, all that. But where is that? That's a good meditation. Where is it? Whether that is in your nose, in your belly, where is it? Are these covered all everything? So that means they would be numberless I, because numberless atoms. They're numberless atoms, so they were numberless eyes, numberless people. Oh, numberless I. You understand? Every covered everything. Numberless I. So where is it? Inside your brain or belly or okay? That's good. So I think finish. due to all that past, present, future, merits, clothes, by me. Three time merits, clothes, by numberless sentient, numberless Buddhas. May that Bodhi, Jita, precious total enlightenment, source of all the happiness, success after enlightenment, for one supports, and they may be generated in the heart of all the six realms sentient beings. All the six realms sentient beings are our family. Our family. Yeah? So all their heart and in the heart, everybody in the world, in the heart, all of us, in the heart of all of us, our family members, those who are already dead, and those who are living, in all their heart, to be generous, without delay, in seconds, and it was hard, but the jita generated to be increased. Chandra Sanjo Rinpoche Maje Vamna Dik Cheva Nyamba Me Vaye Kone Kunda Bebo Then to realize emptiness, emptiness only. Tongwe Tonye Tawa Rinpoche Maje Vamna Dik Cheva Nyamba Me Vaye Kone Kunda Bebo Us to be able to cherish every sentient being more than a sky filled with dollars or the curse of the diamond or the silver or the wish grand jewel, even more than that. And then to be able to cherish every single sentient being. Then yourself to be wish fulfilling towards all the sentient beings without any effort. Thank you very much to everybody.